One more method available for us to concentrate our ore is leaching. So what is leaching and at which condition we have to use leaching process to concentrate or to participate dressing of our ore? Here in such cases or in case ore only soluble in solvent where gong insoluble. In such process the best method to concentrate our ore is leaching, by using leaching process. That means, once again, the ore, selected ores may be with some impurities, they are called as gongs. During the process of concentration, if the selected ore, if gong is insoluble in solvents and only ore is soluble in solvents, such type of ore with gongs, for the purification or concentration of that type of ores, we have to use leaching process. Here, let us consider some examples for leaching process. I would like to consider leaching process of leaching process of aluminium. Once again, leaching process of aluminium or leaching process of alumina from bauxite. As we explained in our previous class, the most important third element widely available in the earth crust is aluminium. It is available in earth crust in the form of bauxite. So the available bauxite may have some impurities. The bauxite which is used as an ore for the isolation of aluminium metal consists of some impurities. It may be with some impurities like, so what are the impurities generally present with bauxite? Silica, SiO2, iron oxides, FeO, and also titanium oxides. So what are the bauxite will have some impurities like silica, iron oxides, titanium oxides. In such cases, to eliminate these type of impurities from the bauxite, or this is considered as gong, to eliminate this type of gong from our bauxite ore, we have to use leaching process. In this leaching process, the powdered bauxite, the concentrated or powdered bauxite Al2O3 is reacted with concentrated sodium hydroxide. So first, what we are going to do here, by using the previously explained topics, some amount of gong will be eliminated from the ore, bauxite ore. And also, if there is some impurities, which type of impurities? Silica, iron oxide, titanium oxide, type of impurities may be connected or present with bauxite. To eliminate such impurities, we are using leaching process. In this leaching process, bauxite is used to, the powder of bauxite is used to reacted with concentrated sodium hydroxide, and when the reaction takes place and produces sodium aluminate AlOH taken 4. What is the name of the compound? Sodium aluminate. Here the 2 moles of sodium aluminate as formed as the product. During this process, now the sodium aluminate will be left as, or the nature of sodium aluminate, it is an alkaline in nature. The formed sodium aluminate will have alkaline nature. To eliminate alkaline nature of sodium aluminate, AlOH taken 4, it is reacted with, or towards or onto sodium aluminate, the carbon dioxide gas will be allowed to pass, and which produces Al2O3.xH2O plus sodium bicarbonate. That means the passed carbon dioxide may react with sodium metal and somewhat the components of sodium aluminate and forms sodium bicarbonate as side product, where alumina is going to form in solid form. Now the formed alumina, Al2O3.xH2O, when heated nearly about 1473 degree Kelvin, when it is heated up to 1473 degree Kelvin, it yields as the formation of pure Al2O3 plus XH2O. It will be eliminated as gas, whereas the leftover one is solid. So this is about leaching process of alumina from bauxite. So the finally expected one is alumina. So the bauxites are converted into pure alumina with the elimination of gangue, which may be contaminatedly present with this. Here, this is here. Now in the first step, while the powdered bauxite is going to react with sodium hydroxide and water, we have to maintain the temperature nearly 475 to 523 degree Kelvins at 35 to 36 bar pressure. So these are the conditions required to perform the reaction between bauxite ore with concentrated sodium hydroxide to form sodium aluminate. The formed sodium aluminate with alkaline character. To eliminate alkaline nature of sodium aluminate, it is reacted with carbon dioxide.